Hey, how's it? Good morning. Oh, starting off nice and early this morning. I've got coming around full circle with another song actually from A Perfect Circle, and this one is Judith. And you know, the last video I did that had to do with Maynard and Tool was Wings for Marie 1 and 2. And so everybody says, please, please, please do Judith. So I'm here. I'm not familiar with the Perfect Circle except for the last song I did. So, you know, I'm trying to learn a little more about, you know, all these side projects that these musicians do, like Maynard and everybody else, which is so amazing because 85% of the bands and the artists and stuff that I've covered on my channel thus far have all these great side projects that actually show more of their powerful palette of creativity and artistry and musicianship. You know, over here they're doing soft jazz or jazz or you know, and then over here they're doing thrash metal, then over here they're doing, you know, and it's really, really super cool. And so A Perfect Circle, Judith. It looks like it's a very well-known song. Quite a few views on this video. Also, I want to thank everybody so much who have been to buy me a cup of coffee, because you guys know that my channel's not monetized, and also it helps me with what I do with the kids. Since I can't visit kids in hospitals, I, you know, send out a lot of videos for them, you know, special birthdays and shout outs and confidence calls and stuff, and that really helps me out. So I want to thank you for that. And also, these are the headsets, the AKG 240s. I always say that. People who are on my channel go, oh, there it is. Hey, I'm even going to put a link for the cap, because somebody said, dude, this is the craziest cap. I went, okay, fine. I put a link down there. Also, there'll be a link for this video below, a link for Perfect Circle, Spotify, any music you may want to buy, vinyl, and so on and so forth. So, anyhow, let's do this. Perfect Circle, Judith. All right. Jeez, wow. You know, there's a lot of things happening here. If you're not used to, if you have never seen me do this before, I'm going to do a little bit of theoretical breakdown here, but mostly it's about nuances. It's about the sound. It's about the engineering, the production, the arrangements. And even though I can hear Maynard, I'm still listening to his voice first and foremost, and I don't look up the lyrics, so I can just completely dedicate my ears to the music, and I try not to watch the video. All that being said, the first thing I want to bring up is the guitar. You know, we're if you're used to listening to Tool, it's you know, the guitar in Tool is more organic. It's very raw powered sounds, except for effects that Adam puts in to do certain things. This sound here is a powerfully, I want to say a pristine tone focused sound. And then there are the side effects that actually kick in and out and stuff. The engineering is really fantastic because they're moving the guitar around in certain sections and stuff. The slide guitar playing too plays into a very kind of like here. It's kind of like a kind of a vibe, you know, it kind of tugs you in and out. The drums I want to bring up, I'm not going to say, you know, the musicians, we already know where they're at, right? What's my favorite saying? Third Eye Purple level. And because I also don't know their names, I don't want to disrespect them and just say, oh, this side. The bass playing is insane. The drumming is insane, but the engineering, I want you to listen as we move forward to how the snare is really focused and centered, but has a nice kind of plate sound to it. That's a reverb sound to it that gives us this big wide ambience, but how socked in that kick is right down the middle. And it has a nice little thud sound, kind of like you might think your heart might sound like a thud, which is tricky. I mean, engineers use many different techniques in order to get the kick sounds they want. I've mentioned this before. You can put a blanket in it with a mic, a blanket around it, cover it, open it, leave it open, pull the mic out and stuff. Whereas most of the kit usually is a mic on top of the toms, mic on the bottom of the snare top, and then you have these two big overheads, not big overheads, you have these overhead mics that'll pick up the nuances of the cymbals and the hi-hat too. Then, of course, Maynard's voice here in a perfect circle is a lot more forward in the mix, and he's got this beautiful pattern that he's doing with his melody. But at the end of the hook, where this is kind of this little dark ride, there is a resolution of this melody into a kind of a very wide open, very positive vibe. It kind of reminds me a little bit of Jeremy from Pearl Jam, how that there was that one note at the end of the phrase that kind of broke you free. It was a vibe that kind of broke you free and kind of threw you forward. So I sometimes get a little lost when I'm really so wrapped up in the listening, first time listening, trying to take notes and everything. Did I write something? Yep, I got everything I wanted. Okay, let's keep going. I'll go back a little bit and let's do this. Was a really super chord ending, that chord that they chose there to end that with. Gosh, Maynard's voice in this project, and I know there's so much more Perfect Circle I got to bounce into, but that was a huge note. And it wasn't huge that it was so much the highest, as much as you could feel the highest that he's ever put out, you know. you could just feel the power in his voice and the crispiness in his voice. The bass playing is that driving, you know, riff that locks, that kind of sits, it kind of gallops faster than the chug. So the chug that's going on in the verse, where it gets kind of quiet and it's junk, gunk, gunk, dang, while Maynard's doing the main part of the verse, that bass playing right through that whole thing is just so, so cool. Now, of course, in the video, I thought it was cool that the bass player was taking her hair and wrapping it up in that little break in between before she came back in. When I do this, remember, what's this, everybody? This is the universal sign for chicken skin. And whenever that turnaround kept coming around and firing off and then ended up on that glorious note with that big, wide-open feeling, that was like the deliverance of it. That was the delivery of the power of the song for me. And it did, and just because I said it, it kind of reminded me a little bit of Jeremy from Pearl Jam. It definitely stood out on its own. There's no two ways about it. I've got to come back. I've got to listen to this a few more times. A lot of times when I render these things out, I listen to it and I go, man, I forgot to say something about it. And if that's the case, I'll always pin a comment on top and always add to it. But wow, this was crazy, crazy, crazy cool. Great way to start off my morning. I got to drive and do some stuff a little later in town, so I'm going to definitely put this in on my playlist and stuff. And I'm going to listen to this a few times on the way out. Thank you so much for hanging out. Thank you so much for suggesting what you do. Please, you know, put that in your comments. Once again, the link for this song, Perfect Circle, Spotify, vinyl, and all that will be below. And also for a cup of coffee, should you think I deserve it, if you'd like to buy me a cup of coffee, that link will be down there as well. And if you're still here, type in, I'm still here. I'm going to see how many people hang out this far. Anyhow, thank you guys very much. I got some more great stuff coming around the corner this week. But you know how I like to end this. So everybody have a great day. All right.